guys, what we're doing is we are getting ready to make a bonnet wrap. The first thing you want to do with your Ankara is you're going to take off these stickers. The best way to take off the stickers is to make sure that you use a cloth, and that way they'll peel right on off. One moment. Okay, now that we have our cloth, I'm going to go ahead, cover, use your steam. Continue to heat up the sticker. Comes right off. The next thing you're going to do is, what I did was I measured my head. I measured all the way around. You want to take whatever that measurement is, fold it in half. Mine measures, when folded, at least 10 inches. So you want to keep your measuring tape here, and you want to mark 10 all the way down. So to make this simple, you want to take a crayon or some type of marker. This is your markup fabric, or you can use your actual fabric. And you're just going to mark, making sure that it stays at the center point. And then your measurement, all the way across. This is just creating your circle. Now you have your perfectly cut circle. Okay, it's only popping, but this is big enough. I'm going to keep it back folded. Take that, put this aside. Folding it again. Pattern. I'll go ahead and cut right here. Now, you're going to cut out two pieces of these. If you want it to be reversible, the other side is going to be satin, or it's best to use satin for hair because you want to make sure that the inside of the hair is protected. So you definitely want to do that. And the next will be sewing. So we're going to cut out one more of these. And I got a little treat for you. Consider this a bonus. Little print action. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to get ready to press this. It's at set at 400 degrees. And we're going to make sure we put something over top of it to protect our heat press. And this is the image. It's all set and ready. So we're just going to kind of center it as best as we can. I'm going to place something over top of it. Once this is done, you cannot use it anymore. So we're not done yet. This is going to be on the outside or the inside of the bonnet. So you're going to take pieces of this and we're just going to cut slivers so they can kind of cover the almost the whole thing. Take some heat tape. This is Cricut heat tape, by the way. Bring gaps as you go along. So for now, we're going to go ahead and sub this next piece. I ended up just taking it to my sewing machine. I was having some difficulties with my serger, but what you're just going to do is just either stitch or serge all the way around. If you use your sewing machine, make sure you trim the edges. You want to take it, turn it inside out, right sides out. What you're going to do is take your fabric right sides together. This is what I ended up coming up with. This will be on the inside of my bonnet. So you want to face it facing you, your right side of the fabric. Now have it facing that way. You are going to leave at least 4 inches on the outside, and you're going to stitch the very out portion. The next thing you're going to do is once you stitch it, you're going to flip it inside out. And you're going to actually iron your seams. Then the next part is pretty easy, and then it's just the straps. Hold on one moment. What you're going to do, turn it right sides out. You're going to go ahead and iron it. So we're almost done with our Ankara bonnet wrap. Here we go. You're going to go ahead and iron it out. I already started the process. So that's what we're going to do. We got our opening that is right here. And what you're going to do is you're going to actually start sewing, leaving at least a half an inch around the edges, depending on how wide your elastic is too. So we're almost done. The other thing, too, that you're going to do is add your strips. that's also probably the next best thing is to attach the strips as well, but we'll do that last. Make sure that you stitch all the way around, leaving an opening right here to slip your elastic down through here. The next thing you want to do is take your piece of elastic, make sure you attach a pin as such, and then you want to slip it as such, and then you want to slip it through here. It's going to take you some time. You're just going to keep scrunching and pulling, and making sure that you hold on to the end of this. Because it's mine, I generally hold it right here. Otherwise, I just pin it on the outside. Once you have put it all the way through, you want to take your edges at this opening. You're actually going to stitch this down. You just want to put like a little straight stitch there. And then the next portion that you're actually going to do is you want to take this piece and actually fold the raw edges together on both sides. And you're just going to eventually stitch it closed by top stitching. And also finishing out that outside. So here we go. Once you've actually closed this up, you're actually just going to tuck that back down. And actually, what we want to do actually first is kind of close this portion up first, because in that way your elastic can be encased in the top portion. So kind of move that out the way and stitch the very bottom, continuing that inside stitch. So then the next portion, you're just going to take the inside of the raw part of the fabric and you're just going to stitch that close and top stitch right on top and do that for the ending. And then that's the portion for the bonnet. The strips, what you want to do is cut your fabric on the fold. This is about 6 inches. So make sure. Because as it's going to be cut, it's going to be cut again. So essentially, each of these will pan out to be about 4 inches. So I cut about 3 yards, so it's just one long strip. All right. Now we just have the first portion. Reversible. You want to make sure that when you put it on that it's pretty snug. Okay? You can wait on either or. Now we're going to attach our straps so we can get it on. Satin side so our hair is protected. Let's go. So now all I'm doing is, this is my open end over here. I'm just going to cut all the way down. The next thing you want to do is take your fabric and flip it so that way the right sides are in. And you want to stitch all the way down. The next thing you want to do is take your fabric, fold it right sides in, and you want to stitch all the way down. moment, turn the right sides out, and then you're going to iron that down. This is why you need to get you a vintage sewing machine. Begin flipping it inside out. Just tuck, 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 tuck. You can actually go on the outside and start turning it up. So all in all, the strips was about I cut it about 8 inches wide. So that way when I split them, they were about 4 inches wide. So this is 4 inches wide. And once you cut it, you know, once you split it, it ends up being 1.5 yards. Up folding it under and then top stitching all the way down. The next part that I did was I just chose a section and I just stitched just below that line when we started, and I'm just putting the other one parallel next to it. One here, one there. No particular space in between. Just choose a space and just do a straight stitch down. And remember to back tie it.